The Philippines still among the worst countries in prosecuting killers of journalists. The country remains seventh in the Global Impunity Index of Media Watchdog Committee to Protect Journalists. The U.S.-based group says the Philippines tallied 14 unsolved journalist murders in the last decade. The group notes the election of President Marcos Jr. brought hope of a shift away from former President Duterte's campaign of intimidation and harassment of the press. But the watchdog says the recent murders of broadcasters Percy Lapid and Renato Blanco raised fears that the culture of violence and impunity will endure. The Philippine Justice Department vows to keep investigating and prosecuting cases of journalist killings. It says it will take concrete steps to protect journalists and that it understands their role in keeping government officials in check. The National Union of Journalists of the Philippines hopes this translates to the speedy resolution of the Percy Lapid Slay case.
Sa kaso ni Doc Jerry Ortega, no? May mastermind na natukoy, meron ding gunman na nahuli, no? Pero sa haba ng daloy ng kaso, yung gunman ay namatay, no, in government custody. Yung sinasabing mastermind ay nakalaya, nasa Palawan ngayon. Opo, tumakbo pa nga noong Mayo. Napakatagal ng paghihintay na to, no? So, we're hoping na yung paghihintay naman ng Mabasa family ay hindi ganoon katagal.
The Marcos administration also eases travel restrictions as it removes the quarantine requirement for unvaccinated travelers. Pia Gutierrez now joins us on the line for the details. Pia?
Yes, that's right, Ron. Unvaccinated travelers will no longer need to undergo quarantine when they enter the Philippines. This comes after President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. approved IATF Resolution No. 2, further easing entry protocols for inbound passengers to the country. Under the resolution, Filipinos and foreign nationals 15 years old or older who are unvaccinated, partially vaccinated, or whose vaccination status cannot be independently validated need only present a negative laboratory-based rapid antigen test taken at least 24 hours prior to departure to the Philippines. Those who fail to present a negative pre-departure test result will be required to undergo a laboratory-based rapid antigen test upon arrival at the airport. The protocols also apply to unvaccinated and accompanied minors below 15 years old. Meanwhile, inbound travelers who test positive for COVID-19 through rapid antigen tests must be subjected to prevailing quarantine and isolation protocols of the Department of Health. The IATF resolution also lifts the pre-departure testing requirement for all fully vaccinated inbound travelers to the Philippines. The easing of quarantine restrictions for unvaccinated travelers come shortly after government removed the requirement of wearing a face mask on both indoor and outdoor settings, except for public transportation and medical facilities. Ron?
Pia Gutierrez with that story. Thanks, Pia. Philippine officials say repairing roads and bridges damaged by Paeng may take as much as 3 weeks. But Public Works Secretary Manuel Bonoan asserts the agency can only start work once they receive funding for restoration efforts. According to Bonoan, they need an initial 300 million pesos to fix infrastructures and make them more resilient to climate change. The secretary notes many of the structures that sustained damage were very old.
Be very blunt about it. We can restore mobility but not actually the entire structure, no? Mm-hmm. Yung permanent solution. Mm-hmm. Because we have to prepare for the designs, we have to engage yung contractors, and we also have to look for the funds actually to be able to undertake all the reconstruction projects. I think this time now experience, we have to learn from the experience that we have now na dapat yung mga ganyang flood control measures natin, ilalagay natin, would now be resilient to yung climate change phenomenon that we are facing actually. So mas matibay po yung kuha namin ngayon, yung ilalagay namin na mga measures o structures actually para hindi ho madaling masira o hindi masira sa ganitong pagkakataon.